Hi, this is Ajay Anand and welcome to science classes from excelup.com. In this lesson, you will learn about the five kingdom classification. This system was proposed by Robert Whittaker in 1969 and this is the most accepted system of classification. Okay, there are many other systems as well. The five kingdoms, according to Robert Whittaker, are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. You can also call it the plant kingdom and animal kingdom. So, let us begin with Monera. Monera contains prokaryotes and unicellular organisms. Prokaryote means that nucleus is not present, nuclear membrane is not present, or in other words, genetic material is not organized into a nucleus. Moreover, cell organelles, they are also absent. Okay, cell wall can be absent or present. So, in some organisms it will be present, in some it is absent. The mode of nutrition is autotrophic or heterotrophic. Those which are autotrophic can be photosynthetic or chemosynthetic. So, photosynthetic means that organisms, they prepare their food by utilizing sunlight, and chemosynthetic means that organisms prepare their food by utilizing inorganic materials. The heterotrophs can be phagocytic or parasitic. Some examples are bacteria, cyanobacteria, and mycoplasma. Cyanobacteria is also known as blue-green algae, and these are photosynthetic. This diagram shows a bacteria, and this is Anabaena. Anabaena is an example of cyanobacteria. Now, the next kingdom is Protista. Protista contains eukaryote and unicellular organisms. So, eukaryote means that genetic material is organized into a nucleus, or nucleus is present. Along with the nucleus, cell organelles, they are also present. In some of the organisms, cilia or flagella can be present for locomotion. The mode of nutrition can be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Some examples are diatoms, protozoans. So, these are the examples of protozoans. This is amoeba, which has an irregular shape. So, it protrudes pseudopodia for locomotion and for catching food. This is paramecium. So, here are cilia all over its body for locomotion. This is euglena, and euglena has a flagellum. So, usually flagellum is in smaller number, it can be one or two, okay. So, this is all about the kingdom Protista. The next kingdom is Fungi. Most of the fungi, they are multicellular, but yeast is a unicellular fungus. Fungi are heterotrophs, some of them are saprotrophs and some are parasites. Those organisms which feed on dead remains of plants or animals, they are called saprotrophs. In this case, what happens? The predator, it secretes enzymes on the food, and once the enzymes convert the food into simple substances, the simple substances are, they are absorbed by the predator. So, in this case, what happens? Digestion takes place before ingestion of food, and that is why this is called saprotroph. Some are parasites. Cell wall is present, and cell wall is made of chitin. Examples are yeast, mold, mushroom. So, this figure shows an yeast. This is penicillium, which is a mold, and this is agaricus. Most of you must be familiar with mushroom. Mold is, you must have seen yellowish cotton-like growth on stale bread, or stale fruits and vegetables, that layer which appears like cotton is because of mold. Then there are lichens. Lichen is a symbiotic association of alga and a fungus. So in this case, both the alga and fungus, they live together, and both of them benefit each other. So the fungal component, it makes the base layer and it absorbs mineral and water from the substratum or the base, and the algal component utilizes those raw materials and sunlight to prepare food. Okay, the fourth kingdom is plantae or kingdom plant. These are multicellular eukaryotes. Cell wall is made of cellulose and these are autotrophs. You will read about the plants in detail in the next video. Examples are grass, mango, and you can count so many examples. The fifth kingdom is kingdom Animalia. So these are also multicellular and eukaryotes, but the difference is cell wall is absent and animals are heterotrophs. Humans, tigers, cockroaches, they are examples of animals. This flowchart, it summarizes the five kingdom classification. So let us recapitulate with the help of this flowchart. Organisms, they can be divided into two groups, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are those in which nucleus and membrane bound organelles are absent, and eukaryotes are those in which nucleus and membrane bound organelles are present. So Monera comes under prokaryote, and Protista, it comes under unicellular eukaryotes. Now multicellular eukaryotes, they are further divided into categories, cell wall is present and cell wall is absent. So those in which cell wall is present, they can be divided into two categories, heterotrophs and autotrophs. Fungi, they come under heterotroph, and plantae come under autotroph. Those in which cell wall is absent, they are under the kingdom Animalia. So that's all for this lesson. Thank you.